My name is Sophia Beaumont, also known as Sheena Peril, and I'm an author of Gothic and Gaslamp fantasy, as well as urban and contemporary fiction. And this is a video I didn't really want to make. So, if you've watched any of my earlier videos in my writing blog series, then you know that I was supposed to do a three-part series about publishing my latest novel, Magic in the Headlines, which is out now. There will be links in the description below. However, parts two and three never actually happened, and I'm gonna tell you why. I have most of part two recorded. It is on my hard drive, but starting mid-April, I guess, I just started feeling really, really burnt out. And this was a combination of things. For one, I hesitate to call it imposter syndrome, but it's very hard to get motivated to work when you feel it's not appreciated. And I've never had great sales on my books. I'm just going to be honest about that. I'm not great at marketing. The people who have read my books always have nice things to say about them. I usually get good reviews. It's just convincing people to pick them up that has always been a problem for me. And that's one of the reasons why I started this channel, so I could get my name out there and make my audience base larger. But there's another factor that plays into that, and that has been a much bigger problem. And I'm going to get into some health stuff here. I'm going to be discussing chronic illness. Please know, I am not looking for medical advice. I have a doctor. I'm working through things with them. I'm doing my own research. I am not looking for advice. If I ever am looking for advice, then I will tell you and I will ask specific questions. But unless you are my doctor, please do not comment below with specific health advice. So back in 2018, I was having a lot of problems with insomnia. This started the beginning of July, and it went through into the beginning of August. And around the time that I started thinking, you know, I should see a doctor about this, a switch flipped, and I was suddenly able to sleep again. And I went from sleeping 3 to 5 hours a night to easily getting 10 hours a night, and then coming home and napping. And at first I was just like, okay, yeah, I have this massive sleep deficit and it makes sense that I'm sleeping so much because I'm so behind on my sleep. I'm exhausted. My body is worn out. So this continued from August into September and it wasn't getting better. And I was sleeping 12 to 14 hours. I would sleep 8 or 10 hours at night, go to work. I would be nodding off at my desk. I would have trouble staying awake to get my work done. And then I would come home. I would take a 2-hour nap. I'd eat dinner. I might watch a little bit of TV, and then I would go to bed. And that was my entire day. And went to the doctor. And they did a bunch of tests, and it came back that my TSH was high. TSH is a primary thyroid hormone. It is the hormone that goes from your pituitary gland up here to your thyroid gland right here and tells your thyroid, hey, you need to produce these hormones so the rest of your body can function. And when your TSH is high, it means that your thyroid is not producing enough T3 and T4, which are the hormones that go out to the rest of your body and tell it to do things. And so I went on levothyroxine, which is a synthetic hormone that replaces the TSH that your body is making, or not the TSH, the T3 and the T4 that your body isn't actually making. And I felt a lot better. It took a while to get on the right dosage. I think I might have had to have it upped once. I don't remember because I honestly don't remember anything from the beginning of July 2018 through about mid-February 2019. That's just how bad it was. So I went on the levothyroxine, saw an improvement, and I was doing a lot better. But my symptoms still weren't going away. Like, I wasn't falling asleep at my desk anymore, but I would still have to come home and take a nap. I was still sleeping a lot. I was still very tired even when I was awake. My motivation went downhill, and it wasn't a lot of fun. And after I was told that it could take about 2 years for your thyroid levels to even out after you start taking the medication. So you could still be symptomatic, and then after that period, you should be asymptomatic because your the synthetic hormone is replacing the one that you can't make, and then you should be quote unquote normal. Well, my symptoms weren't going away. I mean, I was functional, but it wasn't going away. And then we moved to Seattle in 2019, the end of 2019. And for a while I was doing really good, but I thought that it was just my commute to and from work that was making me feel so exhausted because it would take me anywhere from 1.5 to 2 hours each way to get to and from work. And one of the things that triggers my anxiety is travel plans that don't go according to plan. And this could be if a flight is late, or if I have to get a different rental car, or if the hotel, there's something wrong with that. But it also has to do with my commute. And commuting is very hard for me. I get anxious driving in certain conditions. I hate driving in the rain. I hate driving at night. I don't like driving in the snow or ice. And I mean, I don't think anybody does, but it was just very difficult. And I was taking public transit to and from work to reduce that stress. Also, because parking in downtown Seattle is freaking expensive. So I was taking public transit, and if my bus was late or the train was late, or when I was first starting out, I might get on the wrong bus accidentally, or I wouldn't know exactly where to get off. That kind of thing, that would really just, it would stress me out. I would have anxiety attacks, and I thought that that was the reason why I was so exhausted when I was would come home. So I would leave the house at 6:30. I would come home between 6:30 and 7, and like eat dinner and just fall asleep. And that was it. There was no time for me to read or knit or write or do any of my hobbies after I got home. I would listen to audiobooks on the bus and on the train. I would knit on the train, but there just wasn't any me time once I was home, except on the weekends. And I thought that that was why I was starting to feel so tired. Well, then COVID happened, and COVID, I'm one of the few people that has actually done really well since shelter in place started back in March of 2020. And that's because a lot of my anxiety comes from being out and about and being around people and dealing with things like traffic or going places only to find out they're closed or things like that, changes in plans when I'm away from home. So being at home all the time and having more control over my workspace and who I interact with on a face-to-face basis on a day-to-day, that was really good for me. But still, I could feel myself backsliding. And I just thought at first, I need to get more exercise. I'm not walking 1 or 2 miles a day the way I was when I was on public transit. So I tried walking, and then it was just getting worse and worse. And then I started having these crashes. And I don't want to go into the whole thing, but basically, my symptoms were getting worse and I was getting new symptoms. So I finally went to the doctor at the beginning of June 2021, and got tested. And I have Hashimoto's thyroiditis, which is an autoimmune disease. And I got the test results back, and normal thyroid antibody levels are between like 1 and 6, and mine was almost 111, and all of my white counts were high. So basically, my body is in a state of advanced distress because it believes that my thyroid is a pathogen. So I'm working with my doctor. We're trying to come up with a treatment plan. You can also probably tell by my voice that it is cottonwood season, and I hate cottonwood with a passion. My allergies are just going crazy on top of all of this. So I've been diagnosed with an autoimmune disorder, and that is why I've been so tired and so unmotivated. And because I was tired and unmotivated, I didn't want to record and put out that negative energy on the internet. I try very hard, even though I have sort of a darker brand because of what I write, I also try and keep it positive. My goal is to write dark stories with happy endings. And because I couldn't give a happily ever after ending, I didn't want to be putting out the dark story that was how I was feeling. And a lot goes into this. It impacts my mental health, my physical health. And I also didn't want random people on the internet telling me how I should behave, or I should go on this miracle diet and it'll cure all of my problems. Or, you really ought to lose some weight. Like, I know that my weight is a symptom, not a cause of my problems. And I am physically incapable of it right now. I can't even get out of bed in the morning. I tried going for walks when I would feel really exhausted. I mentioned my crashes. I get really, really cold and I get exhausted. And at that point, all I could do is lay down and take a nap because I get brain foggy. I'm tired. I can't keep my eyes open. And I tried, I just need to get the blood going. I'll take a walk when I start to feel one of these crashes coming on. And I would get to the other side of our building and I felt like I was going to throw up. I felt like I was going to pass out. I needed to sit down. And it finally got to the point where it's just like, this is not working anymore. And like I said, I am not looking for advice. I have medical assistance. I am seeking treatment, seeking help. I am trying to get a referral to a specialist. It's just that I didn't want that feedback coming from the internet when I was in a place where I couldn't handle it. And I still, to a certain extent, don't feel like I can handle that feedback, but I felt that I needed to say something here, especially because I left a video series not even halfway into it. If you want, I can go ahead and create a sit-down chat type of video to go along with the part of the vlog that I've already recorded and tell you more about what the publication process was. But this book did not go to plan, and about 50% of it was because of my health. The other 50% was just, it was bad luck. My editor got sick twice. We had problems with the cover art. We had stuff that I was waiting for that came in late. It was just, it was all around a mess. It felt like this book went wrong from January 1st until it was released on May 15th. Nothing went right. And I can break down some of those problems for you in a separate video, but chronic illness is a part of my life. I've known that for a while. And I wanted to break it down here a little bit. This isn't a chronic illness channel, even though in my work I try to be very supportive of people with disabilities, chronic illness, people of color, people who are queer, anyone who isn't quote unquote normal, the standard healthy white middle class. And I wanted to talk about that here because I felt like I needed to clear the air a little bit. But I also don't want this to become the focus of things. If you want to know more about what I've been experiencing, I will link to a blog post where I talk about thyroid disease and my diagnosis process at the beginning. The current re-diagnosis process and treatment is still underway, so I don't feel that I can write about that yet. That will be coming. I'm just not prepared to outline it yet when I don't know where it's going. So I'm trying to make some changes in my life right now to help reduce flares, but there isn't a whole lot I can do. I just kind of have to deal with it and hope that through additional testing, potentially additional medications, that things can level out and I can get my life back because I can very happily sleep 14 hours a day, if not more. I took May off from writing after I released the book. And I've not been able to get back to writing. I'm still creating. I've been focusing on my knitwear design and writing articles, things like that. But I've not been able to get in the brain space to concentrate on a project as big as a novel. I am still planning my release for October. I will let you know if that changes. But that's where things stand right now. I have to take care of myself at this point. And if things continue the way that they have been, I don't know how much longer I will be able to maintain a day job, which is honestly one of the big stressors that has been influencing why I feel so unmotivated, because my freelance work hasn't really been going anywhere. And now it looks like I might lose my day job in part because of my chronic illness, because I just can't maintain the level of energy that I need to work for 8 hours straight for somebody else. If you have questions, I would be happy to answer them down below. And yeah, if you still want to see discussions about the Indian self-publishing process, let me know. Now that I have kind of cleared the air with this, I feel like I can get back to recording my other videos. So look for more craft vlogs coming soon. I've got several big knitting projects I've been working on. I still need to finish the history bounding skirt. I kind of let that fall by the wayside because the thought of just doing the measuring and the pinning and getting out the sewing machine, that felt like more than I can handle. I'm still probably not going to get into any big major sewing projects in the near future, but I do have some in the pipeline that I would love to share with you. As always, links to my website, all of my books, all of my socials are listed down below and in the description. I know this was not as cheerful of an episode as I would normally want to put out. But if you made it this far in the video, I do really appreciate your patience and your understanding. And I do hope that you'll stick around for the next video. So thank you, and I hope that you have something soft and fluffy to snuggle with tonight. Thank you.